Smile! Hello friends, this is Erol. I am a professional photographer and videographer. As you see, in this video, I will be reviewing Nicefoto K8 TTL.M flash. And as you see here, this flash comes with a nice flash carrying bag like this. You can not only put your flash inside this flash bag, but you can also put your charger, your adapters, your transmitters, and also there is a side pocket here. You can put your smartphones inside this side pocket together with your other small stuff as well. Let me put this one inside and let me explain you more about this flash. As you know, Nicefoto has already similar flashes like this with built-in receiver and with built-in battery power. Why do you think Nicefoto has produced this flash? Because of a few reasons Nicefoto has produced this flash. First of all, this is a new series. It's called K series. In this K series, there are two types of flashes. One is called K8 series and the other is called K6 series. K8 series flash has 800 watts flash power with a guide number of 103, and K6 series flash has 600 watts flash power with a guide number of 89. Another change in this flash unit is the change in battery structure. As you see now, we have only one battery pack attached to this flash unit. With this battery pack, we will have 410 times flash pop-ups at full power. But when we remove this battery cover, we can add here another battery pack. When we attach another battery pack, we will have double flash power, which means that we will have 820 times flash pop-ups at full power. Nicefoto K8 TTL flash has also 10 watt LED lights. Let me show you how to control the LED light. In order to control the LED light, again, we need transmitter. In the transmitter, by using this side button, we can turn on the LED light, as you see here. Now the LED light is on, and then on the other side, we will increase the brightness level. Now I am increasing the brightness level. Now the flash is at full power. Now as you see, LED light is at full power. Now I am decreasing the LED light. Now it is at minimum level. That way we can control LED light. We can even do photo shoot by using this LED light in the night time. Nicefoto has also shortened flash recycle time of this K-series flashes. For instance, even though this flash, this K8 flash, has 800 watts flash power, flash recycle time of this flash is around 2.5 seconds as is stated in the guidebook. But when I tested the flash recycle time, I found that it is around 2.7 seconds. You can find the link to that flash recycle time test in the description section down below. Nicefoto has also improved flash duration time of this flash. Even though this flash has 800 watts flash power, flash duration is around 1 over 2000 seconds. So by using this high flash duration time, we can freeze the action instead of using high shutter speeds, especially in low light environment. I will be using these features in another video, so please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to be notified from all these coming videos. And now let me explain you other features of this flash. We can upgrade the firmware of this flash with the USB port. USB port is located at the back of the flash unit. We need to remove this battery pack. And there is the USB port. We can upgrade the firmware via this USB port. You can change the position of flash holder like this to have much better balance. And then tighten it here. Flash color temperature of this Nicefoto K8 TTL-M flash is around 5500 Kelvin. If you are using Nikon camera like this, this flash supports second curtain sync function. But unfortunately, if you are using Canon camera, it doesn't support second curtain sync function. Since Nicefoto K8 TTL-M flash has built-in receiver, we need to have transmitter to fire the flash wirelessly. But in order to fire the flash wirelessly, they must have a communication. In order to set a communication, the channel number, group number, and ID number in the flash must be the same as with the channel number, group number, and ID number in the transmitter. When they have both same values, channel number, ID number, and group number are the same, they will have a communication. When they have communication, then we can wirelessly trigger the flash. If we have Nikon camera, we need to use this TX-NO2 transmitter. But if we have Canon camera, we need to use this TX-CO2 transmitter. They have a little bit different menu structure, but the functions are the same. Nicefoto K8 TTL.M flash also has heat protection. Working distance of the flash and the transmitter is around 100 meters. Nicefoto K8 TTL.M flash also supports high-speed sync function up to 1 over 8000 shutter speeds. Nicefoto K8 TTL.M flash is both compatible with Nikon and Canon cameras. If you have Nikon camera like this, you need to use TX-NO2 transmitter. And if you have Canon camera, you need to use TX-CO2 flash transmitter to fire the flash wirelessly from a distance. Like previous models of Nicefoto, this flash also supports flash exposure compensation and flash exposure bracketing. The flash also has 15 channels, 3 groups, and 99 IDs. Flash power can be set from 1 over 1 full power to 1 over 128 minimum power level. Flash power change from 1 over 1 to 1 over 128. Flash modes of this Nicefoto K8 TTL-M flash is multi-flash mode, manual mode, TTL mode, FP mode, and high-speed sync flash mode. FP mode, TTL mode, manual mode, TC mode. Please note that in another video, I will try to use all these flash modes and I will make another video. So if you want to be notified from all these coming videos, please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. As you see, the flash comes with its own flash diffuser. When you remove this flash diffuser, you can use other types of light modifiers. For instance, you can use softbox and you can use umbrellas as well. There is umbrella socket here. You can use umbrellas as well with this flash. As you see, this flash with its rich features and with its high power is really a nice option for lighting needs of professional photographers. If you want to buy the flash, you can find the link in the description section down below. Thank you for watching this Nicefoto K8 TTL-M flash video review. If you find my video useful, please don't forget to share it with your friends and please also don't forget to share your comments with me in the comment section down below. Please also note that by using this Nicefoto K8 flash and by using my Nikon D850 camera, I will be doing a professional photo shoot soon. So please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to be notified from all these coming videos. Until we see you in our next video, please take good care of yourself. Bye bye!